Hello there, my dear friend, and welcome back to Warlords 3. Let the adventure continue. Chapter 7. A lone dwarven runner approaches your camp and, gasping for breath, begs an audience with you. It seems that the dwarven mines of Dornoth are under siege from Lord Sartek's foul chaos creatures as well as tribes of orcs and goblins. You ask him about the last dragon shard, but it seems that amidst all the confusion it has been stolen. You must enter the mines of Dornoth and help the dwarves battle their foes, recovering the last dragon shard from whoever has stolen it, most likely Lord Sartek. To claim victory in the mines of Dornoth, Lord Sartek must first be defeated, then you must control enough strong points in the mine to force the other enemies to retreat. Which sounds simple enough, but I can promise you it is definitely not. In any case, let us name our new expendable hero, and let us start producing some of our overpowered knights. Let us go ruin hunting. And I am going to tell you a lot about the map. The reason why it is so bloody difficult is because I already tried to complete it 5 times, and it hasn't really happened yet. But those 3 cave worms will definitely make it a bit better start. But let us get the warrior hero up here and let him take this town. And then we can actually start producing a bit here and a bit there. So we take this one, we occupy it, because it will most likely be attacked at some point. Need to remember the night production in that other village. And then we take 2 of these guys and send them west. And we take the remaining ones in the group and we send them east. Because there's a town to the west and there's a town to the east. Believe me, I know the map quite a bit now because I have tried it so many times and I have yet to come up with a strategy that actually works. And, well, I guess the cave worms, they can't move for shit anyway. I'm going to send you guys north and see how far you can get. Also have you guys might as well defend you useless. Also you, Mr. Expendable Hero. But you will head north anyway. You are going to be good fodder for the enemy. And then we end the turn. The reason why, or at least the normal strategy that I used about fast expanding, that one simply doesn't work because Lord Sartek expands faster than you. That is the red one on the turn thingy. He has more armies than you. His heroes are stronger than you. Although that is pretty hard to believe. Skumlorn hero is almost level 10. But it just doesn't matter. The heroes have like 15-4 stats. And all the items that you could possibly want. So this one is going to be a crazy battle. And I mean, even though I had a couple of good turns where I had Skumlorn together with dragons and archons and Pegasi and lots of OP knights, then it just simply didn't matter. I could still stand him here in a corridor and make him defend stuff, and normally nothing could kill him, but they just sent 6 armies filled with dragons and dragon knights. No, I mean Slayer Knights and Minotaurs and so on, completely destroyed me. You can see already in the first round, you can see the lockdown here, they already won 3 towns. So that is a pretty good start for them, let us just say it like that. In any case, I need to move quickly. I'm going to, or at least the idea of what I'm going to do is I'm going to fast expand certain amount, and then I am going to bunker down and hopefully force them to attack me and be destroyed because I have I'm better at defending than they are at attacking. So I will not sack you because I need your defenses. That town will definitely be attacked. And you, my useless hero, you will join up with a knight and then you don't even know what to do with him actually. But for the rest of you guys, you can just start moving. Especially with the horses to the west and to the east. There are some good towns that I direly need. That's all the movement you got. It's a bit annoying to move in the fog of war, but what you gonna do? And you can't move. Well, I might as well start victoring as well, because it takes too long to move up there. But you might as well move up there and defend, actually. And what else do we have? We have definitely the cave worms. You guys need to move further north. I am thinking that if I get a couple of allies up here, I might try to take one of Lord Sartek's towns. If not, then I'm not going to bother. I'm just going to bunker down and hope for the best I can hope for. But that is going to be that turn. And let us see what the heck Lord Sartek is up to in this map. Oh, in any case, aside from this map being terribly, terribly difficult, then it is all one of the maps I remember most, except that I don't remember it being this out of control crazy when it comes to difficulty. And he's discovering tons of gold and gets new heroes and defeats enemies, get more towns, excellent. But I remember this map because this is the first time that has a indoor environment. I mean, it's just good details. It doesn't change the way you play the game, except that there's a lot of choke points where you can pass unless you are willing to fight the enemies. So you can pass enemies pretty much in all the choke points, and the entire map is made of choke points or long straight corridors that you can pass without fighting. So the strategy doesn't change that much, and the combat doesn't change at all, but you need to consider how you do things a wee bit sometimes. And the reason why I sent Skumlorn here to the north is that there are a lot of ruins in here that I need to explore as soon as I can, because else Lord Sartek is going to do it for me. And believe me, he has more than enough good stuff already. But I got 4 griffins, and that is definitely a good thing. Religious crown fear, I guess. Yes, +1. Not too bad, not too good either. And meanwhile, my trusty serpents will head over here. These are awesome, they have a lot of hit points, and the artwork is beautiful. But that is not going to help me, unfortunately, when the onslaught begins. But I got a few towns that I need to take care of. There are... might as well occupy it, in all honesty. Everything is going to be attacked sooner or later. And I also got some money in that ruin, so I'm going to produce some OP knights. And here I'm going to produce Reavers, a new unit that we haven't seen in some of the other maps. It is a unit that gives chaos +1, which makes them very good to have in a composition, because not only can I then give morale from the Pegasi and Night Lords and the Knights, but I can also debuff the enemy with a chaos +1, which gives them -1, unless they have enough leadership, but that should be enough. And expendable hero, you start heading up here. Oh, should I get some more? I should probably get some training on my don't die hero. And he has 10-2, so hopefully he can take a 2-4 mob. Good. I mean, it's actually risking it, because all these dwarf infantry and runners, they have so many hit points, which makes them extremely strong when defending stuff. So I need to, don't risk anything majorly. Especially like dwarf infantry, they are already very good. I guess I will move my knight down there to make sure that he doesn't die. And you will move up there, I might as well victor you. Yes, I might as well. Oh, but I definitely cannot forget my beautiful knights over here. And don't get arrowed, please. Don't. Thank you. And you to me. I mean, I would want to keep the defenses running, but I don't have any money, so I will sack that one, and I will probably also sack the other one. Then I will have enough money to buy 1 round of production of knights. Don't get arrowed. Don't get arrowed. Thank you. Sack it so we can produce 1 piece of knight, and we can start victorying him up as well. And head north and start defending the town. But there's a couple of towns that I can take in here, and that will be all. Then I will start trying to amassing my forces. That is a new kind of strategy that I'm running, because everything else has failed so far. And but if I get a lot of allies and good stuff in the remaining 2 ruins that are up here, then I'm going to try to take 1 castle away from Lord Sartek. I'm also going to join these up so my hero doesn't die in the next turn. And then I'm going to take 1 of his castles and then try to victor everything toward that castle, just to see if he will attack it with that many units defending. That would be lovely if he would throw away all his units on a heavily upgraded castle. But I'm not afraid of his heavy infantry, but believe me, in 2 turns, it won't be heavy infantry no more. It will be something much, much, much more powerful. But in any case, he only got 1 town. But I know Shaft 1, Shaft 2, Shaft 3, Shaft 4 are like some towns that are over here that the Black Dwarf starts in. So they are already fighting, although the Black Dwarfs are somewhat good at expanding this time. In the previous times I played this map, good. They have just been completely, yes. Fear plus 5. Okay, so my heroes coming on can definitely wreck some stuff now. But I mean, even though that I would normally say that this hero would now be unbeatable, then believe you me, he is not compared to what is going to come for him. But I am going to try to attack one of their towns in the start and hope to actually, bait some of their units into death. But I don't have enough money to don't get arrowed. Thank you. This one is not likely to be attacked, so I will start producing knights and remove its defenses. And what was it I was saying? I will try to attack one of their towns and try to make a strong point and victor units toward it. Well, I might as well just start moving all. See if I can get all those people gathered up. But I'm telling you, this is I think this is the sixth time I am trying to complete this map. And so far I have gotten my ass whooped every time. And it's not like close call or anything. I feel like it should be a close call. That they sent like what is it, city report now. Okay, I actually do have more cities now. That has not happened so far. And I'm allied with the dwarf, and he has a decent amount of cities as well. And but how about the army report? I'm definitely stronger because I got this many bloody dragons and so on. But it doesn't count the quality of the units, only the amount of it. So you can't really use that one for too much. But I will move on and I will see what Lord Sartek has decided to throw against me. But at least my ally even got another castle. Oh, this is actually looking really, really good. But I am not going to get my hopes up, believe you me. I have had almost equally as good starts before, but I got run over completely. But they only got one town. That's the only thing they got. Oh, is this the town? This the time I'm going to do it? And you guys are going down hard. And I'm going to upgrade you. Not going to build anything there, unfortunately. And I'm going to move in to make sure that absolutely nothing destroys this one. Then maybe if I have enough victory to this fortress, I will every time I see the heroes move past, I will simply go out with my Skumlawan hero and destroy them, and hopefully that will be a viable strategy, because I have tried pretty much everything else, and don't get arrowed. Oh, thank you. I'm going to sack these and buy some more knights. I tried all, like, as good as I could to, don't get arrowed. Thank you. To, do some fast expanding and get everything up and running extremely fast. But believe you me, it has just not worked at all. So now I'm going to use a bit a strange strategy and get one forward town extremely fast, and then simply try to produce or stronghold that one as good as I can and see what actually happens, because I'm a bit lost as what to actually do, because they always overrun me with so many armies. And even though, like, a winner's report where the game indicates the, you know, who is likely to win, then I am winning, but I can promise you it is going to change, and it is going to change quickly. So I'm going to wait, and I'm going to see what comes past my lovely little outpost, and then hopefully I can start producing some more knights in my southern towns. And here we go. There is a Lord Sartek hero, and I can promise you, he is a badass. Screw you, Lord Bane, you're not even in this map. And This is don't die, right? Yeah. I'm thinking that I will try to... Well, not sacrifice him, but he is going to be like one hero I can explore with. And I'm going to see maybe how that will work out. Because another city would definitely do wonders, although I do have enough money to actually produce knights in another town. This is going to be the safest one down into the south. Then I'm going to vector him up there as well. Oh, I definitely want the reavers up there as well. So I can get chaos in case somebody attacks us. But I'm pretty sure that that is almost like... That is the turn done. I'm not going to move out of my place because Lord Sartek is going to come, and he's going to he's slowly going to another 8 army hero moving up there. He's going to absolutely destroy the dwarves now, and lots of Slayer knights. And if you saw my video of the last level, then you know how big a pain they can be. Just a group of them was enough to not expand the but postpone the victory by like a half an hour, because they could just wreck all units I had. Are those not getting victored? No, they're not. Everything needs to be victored now, and luckily enough I can make knights here with my remaining gold. So armies will be coming in that town for sure. And that's it. It's going to be some quick turns. And now Lord Sartek is going to destroy stuff. He's going to discover tons and tons of gold, apparently. Jesus Christ. Battle of Waiting Hall, that is one of the dwarfs' villages. Dead. Illidia is a dwarf village. They are going to be dead. And the dwarf temple is also a dwarf village. And they won that one. And Smithtia was also... So, how is the city report now? As you can see beforehand... the dwarves were like almost as big, they were more than Lord Sartek, but now he has completely, you can see that, they were the same. No, yes, they were the same at one point, but then it just completely lost and he's going straight to the top. So there's what was the city, so his history. Okay. So then you can see over there on the map how it changes, okay. But I can't see the map anyway, so I will have to wait. And now I will have to venture into the unknown and you know what? I'm going to venture east this time. Because I normally venture west because there are a lot of easy cities to take, but not this time. This time I will venture east. And what was it that I was thinking? I can't undo movement. The maps get increasingly harder, and I can't undo movement in this one for some reason. Simply because it is a harder map, I would assume. But everything is getting victors, so I don't have many groups to go through and check. And he discovers thousands of gold. Oh my dear! And the throne. The dwarves are probably going to die now. Now or in the next turn. And the K-Borgs, they have no idea what's going on. If I don't take this town, they will also get annihilated. And they got absolutely nothing from that attack. As it was expected. But alright, I will try to go up and take their cities. Because they are like... As far as I know, I haven't even been up here to the north, but I know that they live up there because that is where all the troops normally come from. But I will definitely try to go up there and see if there are some easy cities to take. But I need to be a bit careful. And Slayer Knights, many Slayer Knights. And the dwarves, thou hast been conquered. So as expected. But beforehand, they died in like turn 5, so I guess that's a good thing. But, utter defeat for the dwarves. Potion of Might, nope, not even going to bother. You start heading north. See if there are some free villages up there. Some plague carriers. No, those are ogres. Not ogres, but ogres. whatever that is supposed to be. And now when the city is completely full, I might as well start exploring a bit. And that's that turn. It is a bit of a weird strategy for me to do, but so far, and now he's taking like the shafts one over here to the west. So he has all the towns that are to the north, all the towns that are to the west, and now he's actually heading south. And I will win that one. I didn't even lose a single one. But then I will need to stop victoring my people. Because I also need some defenses here so he doesn't just pass me and go in and kills everything. So everything victored I will remove. Away with you, don't victor anymore. Just start building some defenses down here. Why can't I? Oh, right. Because it is the one that I clicked on. So you just stay there and hope that, I mean, that one is going to be, that hero is going to be so, so hard. But hopefully. This one should be somewhat okay. Okay, I've been diseased pretty hard, which makes me lose my hit points. I'm going to lose a couple there, but I'm going to occupy this one because I have a somewhat decent amount of gold. I'm going to produce more knights, and then I'm going to... Right, I can't move through Fog of War unless I've exported. But I mean, now they can't go, like, across me and take the town. They have to actually fight this hero. And I don't think they have the means to it. Meanwhile, I know there's a Lord Bane town down here. And, and I think I might actually save it and just see if I can get really lucky and actually get this, just going to take a look. So then I just want to start racing their bloody towns. I have tried this map so many times that I'm going to quickly say, oh, that's a lot of money though. So I will wait with that one. So I will build knights there and put some more knights over there. And then I will... Ooh! And then I will try to see if I can make another strong point. But I'm afraid that this hero that could move extremely far, like from all the way up here, all the way down here, that he doesn't go around and rape all my villages. You stay there as well, and we will get more the next turn as well, so... You guys move down there. Yes. And defend with your life. See? That is a pretty easy army compared to what he actually has in stock for us. This one we should win because we have two more rows. But they have so many hit points. Look, everything has 4 hit points in his bloody army. But my knights will prevail. After all, we upgraded them from the last turn, and they have 3 now instead of 2. And if they didn't have 3, then all this this entire row would also be dead. Good knight, you deserve a medal. But you can't get it now, you're dead. Okay, okay, so it's actually a somewhat easy win. But he didn't even have any bloody items or anything. Oh, and here we go. They're heading down here as well. Brilliant. Well, how far can they move? Normally Slayer Knight can only move spaces or whatever, but they have been so upgraded in this guy's favor, that is for sure. So I will strengthen the defense of that town a bit, and he's probably just going to bypass the town and take one of these less scarlet ones, but I'm hoping that he can't move that far, but apparently he can't. Apparently he can. And, I'm drinking Coke. I will win tier 4th with my mighty other hero. Ooh, the Forgotten Tomb. I will take that one. And I will find gold. That's fine. It is definitely better than nothing. And I'm going to have to go through some armies because, they're now spawning all the towns that I am. Can I actually get this one? So much money, but he's going to retake these towns, I'm pretty sure. I have plenty of money. I'm going to raise that one. And then I'm going to defend this one. Oh. move down here and build a couple of defenses, and also... I guess I will send out small hunting parties. And what can we do here? We can go to map info, not the vector, map info, and then make this one the best one. So our beloved Skumlovan hero doesn't actually die. Should be able to defend. Oh, and he's stupid enough to attack. But at least there's not full groups now of Slayer Knights. So normally I would have taken like 5 more towns up here to the northwest now. But now we have a really strong defense in this town that he apparently insists upon attacking. And I think that will work. I have died in turn 11 or something in this map, so... I decided to give up in turn 11 in a different playthrough, so and I'm definitely not going to do that yet. So, major improvement. But we will have to wait and see. We're only 15% through his turn. And now all the... And I mean, this is like the army he's just pumping out every turn. He gets like 5 of these armies. It is absolutely silly. And he said, you're heading the wrong way. This town is not for you. And you can see, because I do have actually a Reaver now, so I actually got minus in some chaos, and I got some fear from the item. So now the Slayer Knight only has 6-4, and Griffins 5-4, so there's no way that they can take this town. But I don't mind for the try. One dwarf runner offers to join me for 10 gold pieces. Screw you. So army report. Oh my god. Is it actually going to happen now? But remember, they only count amount, not how good they are. I am good. I'm going to save this. I think this is their main town. And I need to take it and raise it, because I am so sick of this map. Sorry that I'm a... playing as a coward and doing this. Well, can I even do this? Yes, I can. Wow, so much gold. So I'm going to keep it. And they had heavy infantry and so on, apparently in the town. But I have never seen them use like more than one heavy infantry to just scout with. Insane. But I am really looking optimistic about this one. It might actually work. Well, I don't want to celebrate prematurely, because believe me, I don't know how it is with the AI in this campaign, but it seems to me that if they are in trouble, they can simply, what's it called, spawn units everywhere, how many ever they want. And that just seems to be a big problem in this map, at least. But that town is safe. Oh, right, I had a hero up here. And I can see from the city report that he only has like 2 cities left. Oh, wow. He has as many cities as me still. So he has pretty much all other cities on the map. I'm actually good to follow the road. Takes less movement points. And I do believe this is this, with a capital H. This stronghold is where the cave orcs have entered Duanov. So that is their capital city. So it's fully defended. But I will probably take it, because they always get hammered by Lord Sartek. So hopefully they will accept being hammered by me in this one. But let us see what he's planning. So we got a hero. Please attack my... Yes, come over here and attack my town. I will absolutely destroy you. Yes, this is working. I can feel it in my bones. Going to win this one. Oh, I'm so excited. I mean, literally, I spent 6 hours trying to complete this map, and now he's throwing... I mean, he hasn't shown his best hero yet. I'm pretty sure that he has a hero. At least he did in the other turns, that has like 14 and 14 strength and 4 hit points. And he just wandered around with dragons and so on. But if you... if he is so kind to throw away his hero on that town specifically, then I'm happy. The other times I played it through, he would just went down here and kill everything he could. Where I didn't defend it completely. This I'm going to say, I want to pass this game, this map, I'm telling you. So I am going to play chicken shit. I'm sorry. I'm a, what's it called, a save Nazi today. And hopefully I will have enough bloody units to actually take the next town. Just bringing up some more knights to make sure. Pretty sure there's also, if you, you can go into a boat from the, from some of the British here, and then I'm pretty sure that there are some towns alongside the river. At least I found one, but it was guarded by five dragons, neutral dragons, so I decided to just leave it alone. But I'm sure Lord Sartek already has it. Oh, and I got more units. Oh, I'm going to explore with these guys first. Chicken shit my ass, I'm going to do it. Wow. Not even one. One. And two. Let's kill all of them now? No. I'm just. I mean, this is where he's producing all these bloody knights. I'm going to. I'm sorry, but I know I'm a coward, but I've spent so many hours for this. So I'm going to bloody do this. Although it seems pretty hard. But I know that it is definitely possible. 12-3. That was a good start. I'm going to watch this through. Apparently that helps. Oh. Come on, just hit him once. If all of you get one hit off, we're going to win. Oh, there. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, yes. Okay, so I didn't save anything. It's just the first fight I did, and apparently it worked out fine. At least that is what I'm going to tell myself. And you guys start moving down there, and this is so much going to be the time where it happens. Oh, yes, you just wait. We got defenses pretty much everywhere now. So he's not going to be lured down to strange towns now, so I will start vectoring some units. I feel somewhat safe. And yes. Oh, not a vector up there. That useless town. And that was the same turn we're in, so we move on. And now he's probably going to throw some heavy shit at me. Well, more Slayer Knights. What is it? Yes, they are actually attacking that town. I am so delighted. I'm so delighted. Because in the previous times I played the map, they were just attacking like all the towns that I hadn't upgraded and I hadn't victored enough units for, because I had fast expanded to five different towns up here, so it was completely impossible to hold off these attacks. But now with the fear items and the chaos from the reavers, those with the cool artwork and lightsabers, I can actually fend them off. Please attack the same place. Yes! Oh, and we actually got some heavy infantry. They must be getting desperate. Ooh, I am going to be so delighted if this map actually works out. I have been waiting for this for 7 hours now, and I don't know what to say. Oh my god, I'm also running out of knights. Jesus Christ! And he's going to attack me with more armies. I bet you. But not this turn. Oh, he's coming. Oh, she's going down. And the Dark Dwarves are now completely defeated. So I will need to deal with her at some point. I will rally some of my knights up in this town. Because I will assume that she will attack that one. And might as well get a Reaver up there. And he can reach it perfectly. Hopefully she will attack that town. If she passes me, I'm a bit afraid that I might not be able to actually kill her, because she's probably one of his good heroes. Lord Sartek, that is. And what is up here? Never been up here, but I assume that there is a town of some kind. And what we don't want, don't die, to die, so I'm going to chicken shit it out again. And this one is like a 50-50 fight. I'm going to sack it, I'm going to buy some knights. And then don't die, you have completed your purpose. You guys can return once more. And Don't Die will rejoin Skumloran down in the heavily upgraded buff town down there. I'm going to save again before I push next turn, in case that this bloody hero goes on somewhere else. But I killed the cave orcs, so now it is only me and Lord Sartek. Please attack the town. Yes! There is hope. There is hope. And as you can see, like, he has more heroes than I do. His units are better than mine, and in the start at least, he had more than me. So, how the heck I was supposed to defeat this scenario, I was really worrying about. But this seems somewhat doable now, although we haven't quite won this one yet. But it should definitely be a win. Oh my gosh, minus 4 KS, these Slayer Knights, they are so, so good. And they have lovely portraits. But I'm going to look at the army tab now, and I think I'm going to be delighted. But obviously another hero with aid in his party, and he's going for my weak castle. I don't particularly like it, especially seeing as I'm running out of knights down there. So, you guys cannot reach up there, can you? Nope. So that is a problem. But can you guys reach? Nope. Well, that is a problem. Well, I don't want to lose warrior hero, so I'm going to send my few knights that I actually have here up there, and then he's probably going to bypass it and take the empty towns. But that is something I will have to live with, I'm afraid. So now we have a decent defense there once more. And maybe, if we screw a bit with the AI, then he won't know how to pass this corner. I don't know, I haven't tried that before, but maybe like a thing like that would actually work. But I'm going to enter fourth, and there's like another bloody... Jesus Christ. Why must all of their units have so many hit points? Do I even dent them? That is the question. Oh, there's four of them, right. And how many do I kill? One. And doesn't appear that this is going to happen. Although if I try like before and take a look at how it goes, no, I shouldn't be able to do this fight. Do require some. Going to give it 3 more loads, and if not, I'm just going to retreat from there and wait for my hero to get around the place. No. Not going to happen. But I'm not going to wait, I'm going to let these guys stand here and defend. Because the reason why I can't kill them is because they have +2 in defense. So, else they would only have 9 strength, the Minotaurs. Which would put us on a somewhat more equal footing. But yeah, that one is somewhat easily good defended, well defended, and... Oh... Yeah, as soon as the knight starts being victored up here, I will get to work expanding. But for now, we definitely need... You know what? I have an idea. Kind of overrun him, because I don't think there's any Lord Sartek towns nearby, or one behind that one. So I might just try to overwhelm those Minotaurs with knights. And like a chicken shit, I'm probably going to use the safe method as well, but like losing like 10 of them will not really be the worst thing that could happen. But don't die, we'll continue down towards Skumlorn, and I'm going to save now and see what that bloody hero is going to do. Attack, yes, he attacked it. Although, look at that. 10 free hero, and everything is 13 strength, 4 hit points. And there's just Slayer Light galore. Going to get a sip of coke and watch this battle unfold. I'm actually running out of knights. And what else do I actually have? I don't have a lot else, do I? No, I don't. I might actually have to load this one. I don't want to lose Warrior Hero. It's okay if I lose him, but I don't want to lose the following stuff that he's going to attack, which is going to be everything. And I don't think any of them have any missiles or assassinations, so they will just be stomped by those ones. Nope. Stomped. Stomped hard. Okay, so at least I have an idea about what they're going to do the next turn. Wow. That were some... Quick. Wow. See? And then all of a sudden, they just spawn 3 griffins and 3 heavy infantry. I am going to load that turn. Like, look at... And there were even more Slayer Knights, and now he spawns more Slayer Knights. They're just coming from everywhere, and are going everywhere. But that town, they're not going to take. Look at those armies. Jesus Christ. And if I take a look at the army tab, it's like, oh my god, you are winning completely, because you have 93 armies. But his armies are so much stronger. But we are going to do this where I don't lose this town. And he won exactly with the same amount. Phew. Alright. I might also want to a little quickly fix that town before pushing next turn. And yes, you're not going to get that town. Deal with it, please. But look how... just the amount of stuff he produces. It's quite sickening. But I will load up the game, and then I'm just thinking that maybe, if I'm not a complete idiot, I will upgrade this to a strong point, so it's more difficult to attack. And I will do that one, this one as well. Although then they will probably attack this one, but we will see. But he still managed to get it, with the exact same number. And this one... it's fine to lose that one, screw that. Well, I mean, this is the closest thing I've got to a victory, so I will make this work. Although, like, loading this is taking quite a bit of time. But it is definitely faster than, playing it through many more times. I'm going to try to... no movement, right? No movement. I'm going to try to move these knights in, just in case, and this reaver up here, just in case that he has his eye, it's completely fixed in this city. And then I will upgrade it once more, might as well upgrade you, and hope for the best, although probably not going to happen. And he's still going to attack it, okay. So now we have a few more armies and a bit of defense, but... it just doesn't work. Oh god, this game is frustrating. So cringeworthy. Especially in this map. Yeah, doesn't matter. You can't get through all those knights. And you still cannot get that fortress. I will assume by now that I have made like some kind of a small text announcing where all this saving and loading is going to stop. Because I will need to defend that town. But I mean, we need to try again. He only survives with one bloody unit. So once more, we build, and we hope. This one up here, I can accept losing, but not this one. And yes, I didn't. Screw you, Lord Sartek. I'm the ruler of the Duanov mines. Oh, he got that one, but screw that. And yes, you may attack. Oh no. Oh, this is a major issue. And then instead of attacking my good city, he's now going to attack my bloody weakened city. Jesus Christ. But at least my expendable hero got a level up. But With a bit of luck, we can defend it. At least we have some more knights around now. And something is just telling... Oh, and I also got some items over here. That might not actually be too bad. The Banner of Rage. Morale plus... Oh. Screw that, I have enough morale as it is. And I should have started moving these knights, so they would actually have been here in this turn. But apparently that was too difficult for me. And... What do we have over here? We have more knights that we direly need. Nah. Might be desperate, but not heavy infantry desperate. They could actually have made it in this turn. So I might need to load back and do the bloody thing again. Oh well. Well, that is Warlords 3 for you. If you don't want to restart the map all the time, sometimes you will simply have to be a chicken shit and actually save the game and load it. Because something horribly horrible happened. So I will move that griffin, and these knights will be able to join as well. And then we don't have enough to defeat two groups. Oh poop. If we don't defeat them, then we will simply have to load again and start moving the knights. The first one got defeated, but now I'm going to get pooped on. Pooped on heavily. That is obviously. Wow. Those Lair Knights don't care. And he just keeps on saying, it's just not possible to make that many Lair Knights. There must be some cheating going on. At least they're attacking the correct town now. But I'm sorry, I need to go back into the future. And I need, direly need, to redirect some of my units. Everything needs to be redirected. Everything must be inside of here. And then I must also successfully defend it. It is the only way that I'm going to win this map. Going to take time, but it is going to work. Right, then doing the victoring. Move everything down there, if that is the one that they are planning to attack. Again and again and again now. Yes. It is going to work. Okay, I'm going to move the heavy infantry. Screw everything. And the Ryu as well. Cannot forget that one. And then desperately, I can't raise stuff. Oh, I can. Yes. You're not going to get these CDs. Ah, screw you guys. You will get nothing. Meanwhile, don't die. You will go in here. Oh shit, don't have any movement points. Ah, so they'll take that town instead, probably. Oh well. As long as I don't lose my useful towns, that'll be fine. So, let us take a look. Is he going to win? No, not even that close. I still survived with quite a few troops. And he didn't get my knights, and he's going to attack... He's going to attack the weakened city now, but this time I will have enough knights to face him. Yes. Come on down here. Come on down. Yes. Yes, kill a couple of knights. It wouldn't be the first time. Ooh, yes. Are you able to reach that town? No. Because if we got a dragon in there that has fear plus 5, then all of their strength would just be gone. So now we just need to survive one more turn. And then we will have a dragon inside the town, and that means that it is going to be as good as pretty much impossible to take the town. Because they would have enough strength to do it. I'm just a bit baffled now by all the saving and loading, so I'm a bit confused, but my knights are in place. Yes, and there are many of them. Not going to give up this bloody town, Lord Bane. You weak ass noob. And yes. Move up there. And we need to split you guys. So three of you move over there. Three of you move over there. And then we have enough spots for you guys. And I'm going to save this one as one. Don't need that one anymore anyway. Not going to go back and lose the first map anymore. Mm-hmm. And there's only one Minotaur. Oh my god. Save it as one. Kill that one. Erase the city to the ground. Don't care anymore. Everything must die. All men must die. Okay, save it. Number one. Come on, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it. Attack that town, yes. You silly, silly men. But at least there are no heroes now, so they only got 9, so I'm going to be fine. I'm going to be fine. They can't possibly have... They keep sending those armies. It's absolutely batshit crazy. Oh, I actually got 3 of them. But that one, you're not going to take. Forget it. And yes, why not? More armies with Slayer Knights and Minotaurs, I bet you. Whew. They all almost killed all my bloody knights. Oh, might as well have you there as well. Not that you're going to do much. But I'm going to defend Mr. Don't Die in this town. And I'm not going to victor anything up here, no. And my victory units are starting to be received at this town. That's absolutely fine. Then they can move up and, because it takes 2 turns to victor them, so before I started victoring to this town, these people are still en route. And you stay in there and defend with all your might. I'm afraid that there are more towns out here, but I don't think so. Because it's just like this is like the forgotten way into Dornorf to invade the mines, so I would assume that it is the town furthest away. You guys can actually start moving up there, and I won't need you in that fight anymore. So you guys also start heading north, and let us rid these mines of Lord Sartek. Yes, please attack me. -2. Now they will have 7-4. Although having 4 hit points is just so strong. But I will probably show you that in the next expansion set, Dark Horse, where I think there's a Dwarven campaign. And you can see how incredibly powerful it is. But that one is going to be destroyed. And there we go. And I think that may be his main hero. 14-4. So leadership plus... Jesus Christ. And he has fortify plus 1. Morale plus 1. Oh, that's a difference. But he is actually losing quite a few stuff. Oh, but he's going down to that town as well. And oh my god, he can move for... he can move far. And obviously more units are coming. He has plenty of them. He has endless supply. Why not? And it's so completely batshit crazy, because if you go look at the army report, oh no, I'm winning so much, oh my god. I guess I will... You know what? I guess it is time for Skumlaren to join the fight. Although, I obviously can't... I will load the game, then I will cast Haste, and oh, that doesn't affect him this round, and I will cast Mighty Feast, and then it is time, Battle of the Titans, and their hero may come attack me if they want to, but he wants to attack the town. He is going to die. Yes. He's going to attack the city over there. He's going to die. Oh, skeletons. Oh my god, they're running out of units, finally. No more bloody Slayer Knights. That would be so... And then I say that, and then those guys appear. And they can move forever. I mean, they can only move bloody 18. They shouldn't be able to attack the town from over there. If I'm losing the town now, I'm going to be pissed. Expendable, the warrior has gained a level. Well, of course you have. I will upgrade you because people are going there. And I will let you guys help the defense. So, what items? We should have a couple of items there. Mighty Hero. The silver armor, well, that's pretty shit. Fortify. Sorry for my rude language. Well, seeing as my bloody hero is buffed, I might as well get him to actually fight something. And see how it is going to be. Well, there wasn't even... What? Oh, right, we have Chaos 4. Because of the bloody Slayer Knights. Else I would have been 15-4, I think. And I only survived with the bloody dragons. Holy moly. So I'm going to get one Slayer Knight with me for Chaos. Going to get myself some... two Knights for meat shielding. Oh, and bloody hell. I ran out of bloody mana now. So I think my spells will wear off in the next turn. But now I think that our warrior hero has gotten enough... Oh, what? What, you have gotten some items, haven't you? Well, that's strange. Why doesn't he have a... Well, he should have some items. I'm sure he has items. But I will... I will make him venture forth as well. Alright, I don't know how to count. Going to save this as number 2. Going to override other save games. I don't care. I need to win this bloody thing. And how much leadership do you have now? 5, okay, that's perfect. Although Chaos is a pretty good counter to it. And there's a group of Slayer heroes coming. They might get that town, this town, if they decide to attack it. Oh no, no, and stuff should be victor to that the next turn. I can't move. And these people will not be able to move up there, I think. Nope. So you guys stay there, stay put, and... Are you in a frenzy? Oh, like, what do you know? That's fine. Okay. So we got warrior hero out, scumbag hero is out. And he's probably going to send more heroes at me anyway, because he has an unlimited supply, it would appear. Jesus Christ, but at least they don't have a hero with them now. But he did kill 2 packs of knights and more Slayer knights. At least they're mixing it up with some heavy infantry and some griffins now. And I already lost my entire meat shield. Jesus. Okay, so the most buffed hero I had just got his entire army completely wrecked. Holy hell. But I could saw that the dragon cave got pillaged by Lord Sartek. That is the city I was talking about in here. That was guarded by dragons. Okay, I'm going to save you as number 2. And then you are going to go exploring, because Skumlaon just got his entire bloody pack, army completely and utterly destroyed. And since stuff is being victored there, I feel safe moving out with some of my units. And you definitely stay in here. And... 3 hit points. Yes. I'm not going to move out yet, though. I need some more units in the town before I dare. Might as well victor these towns and some of these towns, so I can produce some meat shield for my Skumlaon hero. Well, seeing as they have like infinite movement apparently, the enemy heroes and units, I don't dare leave this stuff undefended. Oh, and a group of 8 something is going to come and try to kill me. What a bloody surprise. Oh, that's a good stuff. Oh, that's the good stuff. What? I mean, it's not possible. Okay, mixing it up. I think they call dwarf mutants those. What are they going to lose? These are... They should lose as well. How much did I lose? I only lost two. I'm going to save it again. Yes. Alright, number four. Jeez. How can they have that much crap? I'm not even sure that I'm happy with that result. And I'm taking the results quite heavily in this round. The same bloody result. I really want to maybe only lose two knights if that's possible. Sorry, I'm playing a chicken shit again. Better than nothing. Better than nothing. Hopefully they won't attack my hero. Is this going to be the map where I lose warrior hero? Yes. Incredible that I need to take out the cities one by one, then return to get a full army, then take on another city. It's insane. I know there's a seaway from over here to the maps, to the cities up there. So I'm going to take that one with a couple of knights, and hopefully that will make some progress. And what do we have here? Nothing of interest. And my one knight died. That's fine. Go down and attack the town. At least in this map, then, or at least in this playthrough, they're not just skipping the town and attacking all the defenseless ones. So I'm very delighted about that. But I'm not delighted about the amount of Slayer knights that they can just pump out, because I know there's not that many towns up there. And I've only got one group left. Yes, hire as many levels, as many stuff as possible. That should be fine. Chaos. Maybe I should actually get chaos. Yes, I will. And he actually had a point to spare. So Saviour's number 5. Then you guys see if you can attack something. One Slayer Knight. Sack it, get a lot of money, and raise it to the ground. Apparently they are only cheating up here. That is where all the spawn stuff seems to be coming from, so I'm going to push my luck and venture to the west. And now I have plenty of armies in that one, so I will vector some stuff up there. Especially seeing as I've lost almost everything there. Jesus in hell, whatever you want to call it. And I will see what they have down here in that dragon castle. Because I have a vague idea that they can just spawn like whatever they want, wherever they want in this map. Although, looking at the map editor that follows in the Dark Lord Rising and so on, the expansion set, that just shouldn't be possible. But it definitely looks like what they're doing, because still the army report still says somewhat. Still have a lot of cities, but I am going to play this safe because it is crazy. As you remember, every new turn there's a full army, more than one full army, and mostly also an accompanying hero that simply goes down and has all the best units, has items, and well, we can't really have them rampage around, so we need the defense. What I'm saying is that I'm going to play safe, I'm going to use saves, although I think that's kinda, well, not cheating, I mean, but it's a bit cowardly. But having spent this much time in this map, I am more than happy to see it be done. Wait, next turn. What disaster are you going to throw my way? A group of 8 something coming to attack. Come on. Oh, and they couldn't even move over there this time. Something magical must have happened. Only one dwarf mutant. I'm pretty sure they're called dwarf mutants. But I don't think I will know until... I'm not going to lose that bloody Night Lord to that one dwarf mutant. There we go. But we won't know until Dark Lord's Rising campaign, where we can play as the dwarves. But stuff is looking up. I've raised a couple of the towns, so... I mean, they should be losing now. But God knows with this map. I have never experienced anything as difficult. And every other strategy I tried and how I expanded and whatnot, it just didn't matter at all. I just got completely whammed by all those Slayer Knights and Minotaurs. That is so much not going to happen. No matter how many times I save and load the game, that is not going to happen. I need a hero for that town. Oh, I will just wait until the victor away. But for now, I don't want to lose my hero. But good thing that I got some victor units in there. And... oh, did I forget to move those? Oh, you got a long, long way to run, but you will eventually get there. Like this place up here is like the dwarf's throne room, and that is where my dwarf allies, although you can't even see that they were my allies because they got destroyed so fast, they actually started, so that is apparently where they have taken up residence now, Lord Sartek and his ilk. Should also be able to move some of this stuff out. If there had been no activity down here, so I doubt there would be anything. And yes, yes, let's get moving. Well, I think there's only like one town there and one town over there. So these knights are probably going to be late for the party because I'm auto attacking from the ground. That's going to be it. Come attack me and be destroyed. And thank you for not passing my cities. That is really such a relief. But obviously more Slayer Knights, Griffins and Minotaurs. They don't care anymore. And you're going the right way. Yes, come to Papa. Come to Papa. And why they can move so fast? I don't get it. Slayer Knights can only move 18. And that is not 18 movement. And oh. And then because they're standing on land, they get to keep their stats and they are attacking a boat. So I lose half my hit points and half my strength, plus the minus 4 strength that I get from shit. And did I forget to say it? Shit. I don't even feel like moving with my hero because okay, I'm going to take that. It's going to be a problem for a later date. Now I want to destroy some cities over here. Oh, that way more than one city. Oh, that one I can definitely take. And might as well sack it by some knights. I have enough gold, that's for sure. And I will... You are fully upgraded, fully upgraded. That's fine. But they can move extremely fast. So... I feel like moving out Skumlon to defend the area down there. But I'm... thinking that might be a mistake, because then they might take this. We'll wait and see what happens. Meanwhile, I will rampage through this, and should be an easy win, but I'm a coward. Ah, only lost one. Things are looking up, and you can see the city. It's not getting more cities. I thought there was way more in the lead than just that. No more movement, that's fine. Oh, I actually start moving down there instead. Though. Because I can't go through Fog of War, so he decided to go all the way around. Great. And we will wait. And apparently all the focus has shifted from here. So I will be able to move out with some of my units. I will leave you there. Bring one knight with me. Just so we got chaos and morale. And then we will see if we can do this. But the other strategy I actually found in the other maps was that for some reason they started attacking by boat. So I would place my units like here. So they would never get to land before attacking my units. So I would always have they would always have half stats. But they still swamped me completely, so... look at it. Like, I thought that maybe one Slayer Knight, but no. All the Slayer Knights. Come on, don't reach me. Thank you. I got a brilliant idea then. Oh no. Wow. And there were only four griffins before then. Oh, they're flying, so of course they have all their stats. Piece of crap. Oh dear bloody fuck. Yes, give me as much as you can everywhere, please. Okay, so that's going to be a very, very difficult town to attack. Going to save this one. See what happens. Doable. Race the bloody thing. Not going to play Mr. Nice Guys no more. Everything must be destroyed. Another more town to the north. Don't want to lose anything. I did. Wow. I don't want to lose that bloody Night Lord. If there's more towns, I need to... I need to keep him. Jesus Christ. Why are those two Minotaurs so... incredibly difficult. Well, at least if I just survive from my dragon, it'll be fine now. Can't even kill one Minotaur. And I've had you through 7 maps now. And you can't even kill 2 bloody Minotaurs, and you have a bloody dragon on your side. Thank you. Thank you. And there's even more castles. I've never been up here. I didn't even realize there were castles up here. So if he's going to attack this one, I will make a big, big defense out of it. And I will raise you, screw you, and join up with my hero so he doesn't die too quickly. And you people start moving up here, and you can join up with him as well. Well, it'll be fine. That one will be well defended, at least against griffins. And you guys are trying to attack down here? Don't think so. Goodbye. And how far can they move? They can move 22, and these slayers moved all the way from up here or something. So they can move forever, apparently. But there are many things now. You go down there, we need to kill those bloody slayers at some point. And it would be lovely, even though I've sent like 10 groups to the north of this circular room, all of them have been killed before they even got into that corridor. Just shows you how many, too much armies they have. But we move on, and we are playing it safe, as it should be done. Oh no, and here they start. And, ha! I actually got that one, perfect. Why can you move that far? I don't get it. And those I can hopefully kill. And once again they just spawn units as nothing. Completely silly. Yes, move bloody everything down to this town again. I have nothing to defend. So I will actually need to kill those griffins. So this is one again. Hopefully my knights will be able to do the job. My hero can't even move there, so there is that. We're going to try a bit, and then I can't have these rampaging through, so I can't bloody make my knights. So I will need to actually win this battle, or I will be destroyed. Just enough to attack. Might as well save number 2. occupy it. Good. Hopefully, hopefully, this will be able to fend off 6 slayer thingies. Alright, I got the bloody dwarfs. Got the bloody dwarfs! And they can move all the way in. Good. I mean, normally they have 3-3, but now that when they're in the city, they have 6-3. So, that is why they are good. And now I can actually start exploring to the north. Let's see what is up. And, I mean, might as well kill this town. I'm not going to. Sack and raise. Oh, Jesus. It's just that, you know, you saw that there was only one griffin there, and like before, there were only 4 griffins down here, but all of a sudden, they just move out a pack of 8 units, so, I mean, it shouldn't even be possible what they are doing. And can I reach those Slayer Knights before it's too late? Nope, not enough movement. Not even close to enough movement. I guess my knights will just have to valiantly defend themselves and hopefully take out a few with them. But excellent, I'm getting more knights. That's what I need. Start moving north. Need to get rid of this Lord Bane. This has been 27 turns. 27 turns. And if you didn't hear the first 2 times, 20 bloody 7 turns. Jesus. Jesus almighty. So, what do you have for me, Lord Sartek? Oh, so he was not there. Okay, so, seeing as we couldn't see them move, they must have been very close. Well, oh right, yeah, he was actually standing right beside him, that's right. I remember that now. See? You saw there were only 2 griffins down there this last turn. And now there are 12 units. And they take 4 turns to produce those Slayer Knights. So, it feels a bit like we're fighting uphill. Like, crazily, crazily uphill. Are you able to attack? No. What do we have inside the party? That's actually survivable. I'm going to load you so hard. I might actually be able to take this one with me. I might actually do this. But of course, same exact result, even though that I had 2 more in my army and more buffs and debuffs. And I do love the randomness of this game, believe me. But when I spend too many hours on it, one has to sort to, and that's what one has to sort to a bit of somewhat semi-cheating. I hope that you can accept my difficulties in this hard time, and that only one griffin. I mean, where do those 8 Slayer Knight come from? Because as soon as we're done with this, we're probably not going to see them come from up here. Because they can be spawned in some invisible location. But that's just where the dwarf cities are, or where they used to be before Lord Sartek destroyed absolutely everything. Alright, he captured the town there that belonged to me. I will try to take it back with my mighty expendable hero. Do I still have all my heroes? Hero report. Okay, don't die, Scumlon. Expendable. Or I still have all my heroes. That's actually very, very good. And there were only 2 Slayer Knights attacking there, but apparently for some reason they had the ability to produce even more in that one single turn. Jesus Christ. I think that is why I remember this game being so brutal. Because it was nothing but bloody cheating. So it might be very optimistic to attack them against the town. I think I'll stand guard in the corridor, so they can't move out with more stuff. But even though, remember, they have 5 in that town now. It takes 4 turns to produce them. They're going to attack me with 8 at least. I bet you. But we are slowly nearing the end. Oh, I say slowly. My head is completely fucked up by now. Amount of times I played this map. And yeah, this was the same turn, yes. And 0 movement. Okay. We save once more. And wow, and then they just spawn 2 full packs of stuff. Like, I'm sure that in the map editor, you can't make the or they just move them from there. But that should take 2 turns to victor them from this town to that town. Whew, this game. There's just also a lot of the strategy is disappearing from the game if they are able to do stuff that you are not able to do, and they can do magical things like bloody sending their units everywhere to wherever they want, whenever they want. But you will not be able to. You couldn't reach these towns before, so you will go back and defend there. And we had some griffins. Those are going to work just nicely. And you guys return. Well, as much as we can. I will take you, and you will go in there. Because like, apparently they got another bloody army incoming. Oh, dear me. Dear me. But they also have armies incoming in onto their floats. And that is going to be enjoyable to destroy some of these Lord Sartek. Oh no, there's like nothing defending them. Raise them to the bloody ground. Won't have enough to face that one. So what do they have in here? Oh, what is that going to be like? 10 Slayer Knights? No, only 1. It's going to kill... Yes. Hello there, Knights. You, on the other hand, can attack those griffins. That you should be able to do. Race. Oh, Jesus Christ. How much do they have? 8? Okay. That's acceptable then to... Well, just to bloody try to lower the runtime of this video, I'm going to try to survive with more. Because that is just silly. And you can move on. Yes. Move everything. And it is going to be interesting attacking that dragon side thingy, or whatever it's called. Because I can't really send my heroes in there. They can be destroyed by 1 unit if I'm not careful, so I will have to send in like tons and tons of knights. Well, as I normally do. Oh dear. Okay, he's passing me. And why can he move that fast? Oh, another 8 layer knights. It doesn't matter, doesn't matter. Okay, expendable. Well, I actually got to level 3 then. Might as well get some leadership. But did my, yes. My unit spawned here, so I might be... I'm tempted to send them down and kill that Slayer Knight. But first... I will have the pleasure of killing this... the throne cities. That's how I could see, like, here down here in the log, like, where the cities were, because... I saw the map before through my playthrough, so I knew where Lord Bane was going to be. And now I just don't care. Don't care. I'm going to care that much that I bring these knights with me. Destroyed, thank you. And there's nothing else here, if I remember correctly. Another town over here, probably. Priest room. There's not going to be anything in here, is there? So, if I remember, if I think correctly, then there should only be like these two cities left. So how they managed to spawn all these bloody armies, please. He's almost gone, but he shouldn't be able to spawn that amount of armies with the bloody nothing. 4 turns to produce they take. Ha! Great. Yeah, that's right, screw you, Lord Sartek. I want to have this bloody game over and done with. It is no longer enjoyable. Yes, you can't reach it. Good. And they just keep spawning. City, so he can't have more than 2 cities then. It's just city. City cheating mechanic. So he must be spawning like maybe 5 Slayer Knights a turn at random positions, it would appear. And that is pretty hard to play against. I had to rely on the AI being stupid enough to attack my most protected town. And luckily, they decided to do so. I'm not going to win this fight, I think. Not with the amount of stuff that they can bloody produce. And I think they might be doing this in this Fog of War map, because in the other normal maps you could well, I'm going to accept that small setback. I'm going to kill him with... No, I can't even move out with more stuff. I need them to defend, or this video will just drag on for many hours. Well, there's only one left. You can do it. I know you can. It will, however, apparently take some time. Do we have anything nearby? No. Don't want to lose all that poop. You guys can do it. No, you can't. You can do it now. Wow. Do it. Yes. Good. Acceptable. Whew. There's nothing more up here, I'm pretty damn sure. So now... I could actually get this flying, so they can't attack me while I'm flying down there. And this is Gumlon, so I don't want him to lose everything. Apparently the only way that I can kill them is to probably kill all the cities. Yes. Oh, only 6 Slayer Knights. What a delight. Oh, how can you produce? You have 1 town left. Oh, at last. Your scouts have finally exposed the entire map. Okay, so apparently it is true. Yes, 1 town. Oh, yes, he raised it. Oh, please say that I can get down there. Yes, thank you. The game is fucking won. Jesus Christ, I don't want to do this map anymore. Get extra HP, save the bloody game, then absolutely destroy him. Raise the bloody town to the ground. Because if he had captured the town and then he could spawn 16 units there, then I... that really would have been long, and it's already like 1.5 hour long. Jesus Christ. But okay. He's dead. The memorable map. And I think I know why I remember it so well. It's now finally done.
You have proven a worthy opponent. But
yes, I
have. Will surely defeat you next time.
No, you won't. Total victory. Jesus Christ in hell. Oh my god. Done.
This is becoming intolerable! Sartek is defeated and you have the dragon shard! But I still have some surprises for you, mortal, and all of them are unpleasant.
Oh, so that they are, eh? Okay, so I can upgrade some more hit points for some of my units. So if I upgrade my Night Lords, they will have 4 hit points. And I can upgrade some movement. Didn't get any need. Anything further than before, so might as well throw it in the bloody reavers. Well, there we go. We're going to save this as number 7, and I'm going to say okay, and then I am going to quickly continue. I'm not going to end the video quite yet. I am going to quit, and apparently that went all the way out of the game, so I will end the video there. I will see you guys in the next video, and until then, good luck and have fun.